Hello everyone, I am going to present the work entitled Automatic Generation of Synthetic Palm-Based Images, a nature-based approach, which was developed in the Pattern Recognition Technology Research Laboratory.
The identification of people through biometrics is based on the automatic recognition of the individuals through physical or behavioral traits which must meet certain characteristics. They must be unique to each person, permanent and universal. There are several biometric traits. The best known are the fingerprint and the signatures. Other less known are the face, the iris, the gaze, the voice, the palm print, and the shape of the ears. All these biometric features have common characteristics that they are exposed to the environment, making them susceptible to forgery. Hence, our aim is to contribute to other biometrics that are more secure, such as recognizing people through palm veins. The interest in studying these biometrics lies mainly in the security they provide, since the palm veins are not visible to the naked eye, and most of the time we keep our hand in a half fist. In addition to this, there is no wear and tear as with the fingerprints. They also guarantee the sample's vitality and provide high hygiene, since the acquisition device do not require direct contact with the device. The disadvantages are the acquisition devices are not standardized and that the images have a long resolution. This is due to rotation and translation problems caused by the non-contact device and influenced by light and temperature of the environment. In this context, the investigation has mainly focused on robust feature extraction using different methods, such as skeleton-based, minutia-based, and deep learning. The latter have given good results in different computer vision areas and is highly dependent on the amount of data. In evaluating algorithms for biometrics identification, there are two problems associated with the number of data. On the one hand, there is the verification where different images of the same user are needed. On the other hand, the recognition where many images of different users are required. In this context, research has been oriented toward verification where different image augmentation methods have been employed. In the case of recognition, the problem lies in the sampling of different users, with in addition to being called brain security problems. Among the palm vein databases available to the public are Cassia, Vera, Put, PolyU, ProtoPain, and Technocampus. These are characterized by having a limited number of individuals. The database that has the most is PolyU with 250 individuals. Other databases were built by research groups, some of which are shown here. The second database is characterized by having a large number of images, 600 people, and being plus by having high resolution images. This database, although they have allowed the development of many investigations, the limited number of images substantially reduced the quantity and quality of analysis methods and algorithms that can be implemented in the scientific work. In other biometric domains, such as fingerprints, synthesized database enables the respective biometric processing technologies rapid advancement. For the synthesis of the palm veins, it is first necessary to determine which veins are observed in the biometric images. Now, taking into account the anatomy, the palm veins are divided into two sets, deep and superficial. Of these, only the superficial ones are perceived due to the optical limitation of the acquisition device. The merchant rate of visual penetration is between 0.1 and 3 millimeters. In this image, we can see the superficial arteries structure. It is composed of a venous arch from which the common digital arteries branch off. This is in turn branch in the digital arteries that go to each of the fingers. In addition to this structure, the superficial part of the palm presents complex vascular patterns that ensure constant blood flow when the hand is in motion. This fact allows us to suppose that the venous network observed in the biometric images is formed by these two types of structures, especially by this venous plexus whose topology is unknown. In fact, the anatomy atlases mentioned it briefly or simply describe it. It has a random venous network, hence the interest in working in this area. In this work, we use the vein pattern generated by Pisarum polycephalum as an analog of palm veins. Pisarum polycephalum is a mole capable of sensing local concentration gradient, and the presence of nutrient gradients alters the structure of the outer membrane areas. When the plasmodium can locate nearby food sources, protoplasmic veins appear within the plasmodium, effectively connecting them. Pisarum pattern formation can be interpreted as a complex mechanism based on the two behavioral efficiency requirements of foraging and nutrient transport efficiency. The mechanism used to meet the requirement are growth, movement, and area reduction. The algorithm we used was proposed by Jones, which consists of an agent-based model. In this case, each agent consists of a body and two sensors that direct the movement toward the nutrient sources. The food emanates chemonutrients at each time step and diffuses independently into the environment through an air filter. The process of developing the palm vein database can be seen in the flow chart. First, the venous network is generated, taking into account the algorithm that simulated the growth of the pisarum. In the case, the gene move randomly along a square corresponding to palm region and serve for most optimal path to join two food sources located at the midpoint ends of the square. In the search process, the increase in the number of iterations from 350 to 700 causes different types of patterns to form, and the number of loops is smaller. In analogy to the pattern of the palm veins, the growth of the pisarum with the food sources located at the extreme of the square area allow an optimal simulation of the blood flow from the proximal to the distal part of the palm, and the variation in the number of loops is associated with the movement of the hands. Second, the image enhancement process has two main functionalities. On the one hand, the blurring effect aims to smooth the scattering of points corresponding to a gene to obtain a continuous network. Secondly, we play brightness variation due to near illumination effects during the acquisition process of real-world device. We randomly add brightness and apply a Gaussian blur kernel to images obtained by the Pisarum generator for these purposes. Afterward, the enhanced image of the synthetic vascular network is blended with a random generated palprint image to add palm texture details. Random palprint images are created by using a self-trained GAN model with StyleGAN 2 architecture. For training the GAN model, we choose the visible spectrum of the CASIA database because it was called following the same methodology of palm vein images. We used the official implementation of StyleGAN 2 of NIVIA. After running the above process, we obtained the finally synthetic palm vein image, which replicate Android sample used in palm vein recognition system, thus aiming to create a synthetic biometric database. The next step of the purpose methods ensure the uniqueness of subject in the synthetic database. Finally, before including a new subject in database, we increase the number of samples from the generated palm vein image by introducing random variation in rotation, translation, brightness, blurring, and zoom. These effects occur during the acquisition process of palm vein images on non-contact device. They are compatible with real-world effects in palm vein system. We obtained a synthetic palm vein database called a natural-based synthetic palm vein database comprised of 12,000 images corresponding to 2,000 different subjects. Generated images were compared against real images from the Vera output dataset, which are where the vein pattern is better observed compared to the remaining public databases. From the mentioned databases, we randomly took a sample of 10% of the total images to be compared with the same number of images from our database. Some sample images from the PUT, PERA, and the Purpose database in this work are shown in the slide.
To measure the degree of similarity between real and synthetic images, we first apply a qualitative assessment by comparing the texture similarity using the grade level concurrence matrix GLCM. Figure show plot obtained for GLCM statistics that represent the covariance confidence ellipse of the GLCM dissimilarity against the GLCM correlation. From the representation, we can analyze the similarity degree of texture of real and synthetic images, take into account the intersection of confidence ellipses, the similarity of the synthetic database with the PUT dataset resulting in a 38-85% overlap, meanwhile with the Vera dataset resulting in a 72-54% overlap. Therefore, the Vera database has a better similarity in terms of texture.
The second measure was the Structural Similarity Index, SSIM. The qualitative evaluation based on the SSIM compared to images according to visual parameters such as illumination, contrast, and structure. The SSIM is a multiplicative combination of these three terms, and its values are generally in the range 0-1. The value 1 indicates that the images are equivalent, and 0 indicates that they are different. The color intensity variation represents the range of similarity between each selected pair of samples from the two databases. From the PUT dataset, the average value of 0.4619 with a standard deviation of 0.0524, we show a median similarity between them. In the case of the Vera database, the average value of 0.5583 with a standard deviation of 0.0755, obtaining a more remarkable structural similarity than the PUT database. The results are also consistent with the texture analysis previously performed. To quantitatively measure the similarity of our synthetic database and the real ones, we extracted the imaged features through an inception network and classified them using a binary classifier based on the one-nearest neighbor with a loop scheme. The binary classifier aims to predict the class of real 0 and synthetic 1 images, thereby to the estimate their similarity is assumed that the more the classifier misclassified, the data set will be more similar. Besides, we compute precision and recall metrics as an additional quantitative analysis. These metrics allow quantifying the amount of synthetic data generated by a part of the real distribution and the amount of real data that can be generated by a part of synthetic distribution. Table can be noticed that the classification accuracy for the PUT database was 71.9% and for Vera was 63.4%. The results show the classifier could not differentiate the characteristic of the two groups of images. This behavior was confirmed by the precision and recall distribution for F metric. Finally, the conclusion of the work. We present a methodology for the generation of synthetic palm vein images that mainly consider the simulation of the vein pattern structures. We obtain a synthetic palm vein database called Natural Base Synthetic Palm Vein Database, comprised of 2,000 different subjects. Both qualitative and quantitative measurement results show that the generated database has some similarities with real images. Despite the promising effort to synthesize palm veins images, there are several factors to consider. It is also necessary to consider differences in architecture, such as branching angles and thicknesses. We are working on it. The generation of the synthetic database is incremental. Therefore, we will continue to increase its size. The palm vein database developed in this work is available on our laboratory website to research community. Acknowledgement: UCM Doctoral Scholarship from the Catholic University of Maule and the Pattern Recognition Technology Research Laboratory. Thank you for your attention.